Welcome to this week's Studio Chat. Today we're talking all about inspiration, getting inspired to make artwork, and what you can do about it. As always, don't forget to leave a comment below or leave a question down below. I'd love to hear from you. Okay, so let's get started. Topic is inspiration, and I just want to tell you that don't wait to be inspired. Okay, a lot of times people sit around and they say, well, I'm just not inspired. I can't find anything inspirational to draw, or I'm waiting for something to be inspirational to paint. Please don't fall into this dreary category of people who sit around doing nothing and wishing and thinking. Okay, get out there and do something. Draw something today. Paint something now. You won't be inspired suddenly, miraculously out of nowhere, and then suddenly become this great artist. Inspiration actually develops from working in the medium. So just pick anything, draw anything, and follow those inclinations. So pick anything. I'm looking at a stool. There's actually a stool right in front of me. Okay, so how about this? I could spend the weekend drawing stools, and then maybe explore those ideas a little bit further. What do they look like under one light, under two lights? What happens if I have a really long cast shadow on one of these stools? Point being is, I'm not waiting for inspiration. I'm going to create my own inspiration. And I will tell you, what ends up happening is, if you study subject matter for long enough, it actually becomes inspiring towards you. You'll start to notice little things. I'm using this stool as an example over here. Okay, you'll start to notice that, hey, this stool's got square legs and a rounded bottom, and there's all kinds of interesting things that happen, and the cast shadows might start to become attractive, and I'll be like really in tune with the stool, and that becomes inspiring. And then maybe I'll notice some things about the stool, perhaps the wood grain, and then I'll start looking around my house, and I'll say, oh man, there's some other wood grain objects here. I wonder if I could paint them in a way that I painted this stool. Okay, hopefully you're getting the idea here. So the message is, don't wait to be inspired. Just do. Do first and let the inspiration grow and happen because you're doing things. Draw something. Paint something. Get into it. Make all these observations. That's what I love about realism, by the way. I love the fact that when you're forced to study something, I mean, man, I can look at an apple for 3 hours, and I'm working on all the little details. And the more I work on that apple, the more I paint it, the more I discover every little thing about that apple, my appreciation for that apple just goes up more and more and more. And by the time I'm done with the painting, I'm not thinking, oh, I never want to look at another apple again. I'm thinking, man, that was awesome. And there's so many things about that apple that I never noticed before. And then I'm inspired to paint more apple and then more fruit and things like that. So the moral of the story is, don't sit around waiting for inspiration. I think I've said this like 5 times already. Just do. Make it happen. Draw something. Paint something. Get into it. And I think you'll find that you will become inspired over time. All right, guys, leave a comment below. I'd love to hear from you, and I'll talk to you next week.